Hello there, viewers. This is, as the intro said, this is being played in turbo mode. I'm not going to really talk too much, but I'll just put in my whatever, my little comment or 2 cents, whatever, in the clips from there to give, like, context or whatever, give you information on what I'm actually doing in the clip. Other than that, between the cancerous memes and loud noises, enjoy. Or something, whatever you do when you watch this shit. The interesting about these little mounds of cotton or dust or whatever they are, you only have to check the last one at the end of the room. None of the other ones are required to meet Susie. So we're skipping ahead to the tutorial. There's a lot about this one, really, that's kind of hidden. Or, like, little details that Toby Fox put in there. Pretty much, you just have to fuck with him, like Proof I'll say. And we're just going to do the main extremes, where we just hug a shit ton and attack the hell out of the dummy. That's it. Enjoy. At the end of the fight, Rousey gives you probably one of the most awesome items in the game. We'll see it in action later, but for now, let's just go back and reset this real quick. What I'm trying to say is, I respect you so much that I'm gonna slam you with it, with the physical manifestation of my respect. Okay, back on the topic of Rousey giving us the best item in the game. Well, I'm going to show you something that you probably didn't know that the manual can actually be used for. The manual even works on multiple targets, not just one. Though, the manual doesn't work on everyone, as you'll see in our next encounter. Now, if you're like me, and all you want to see is the fluffy boy smile, you'll like this. What you do is when you receive the ribbon, just mind game the fuck out of Rouse it, and just equip it on him instead. I don't think this is too secret, because I found this my first time playing the game ever, but if you just say no to this guy, he'll just continuously lower the price of the tutorials until it's only $1. Now right here, tutorials, like, I already know a lot about this game because I played it so much, like, I doubt they can tell me anything that I don't know already. Now for this encounter, there's actually something pretty interesting that happens when you lose the fight, actually. I'll show you that in a bit. Okay, so the game just crashed. That wasn't what I was trying to show you guys, but as far as I understand, this is, speaking from future, this is the only place where this game crashes in turbo mode, but I'm gonna revert it back to normal and show you what I meant, what I intended to show you. Oh my goodness, the game feels like it's underwater. It's something. Yeah, I got so used to playing on turbo mode that it feels like I'm in slow-mo right now. That's something. Thank you. From here on, it just continues to loop. Another cool thing I found while recording this is Susie, she doesn't actually give up any equipment that she has on her. She will refuse to. Though, she will allow you to swap other items, so if you give her something that, you know, you want to get back, you better hope you have something to swap it with. Now, because I know you guys love to watch me struggle, I put in all three attempts that I did, the third being the successful one. I'll write the timestamp on screen of where to skip to just get to the successful one if you want to, but each of them is like 2 or so minutes long, so not that long, but if you just want to skip ahead, the annotation will be on, or it'll say on screen where to skip to.
Anything. can do anything.
Now, at this point, I realized that I'm making such a big deal out of what it really, you know, how to beat Jevil. He literally tells you how to beat him at the beginning of the game, dude. It's just so simple. Just don't let your HP hit zero.
Anything.
can do anything! I can do anything!
Now, I did actually defeat Jevil before the Chaos King, but I mean, yeah, he's kind of a letdown compared to Jevil, obviously, but I decided to throw it in just because it's kind of cool to watch and it's really quick. So, enjoy. When you return to school, there's a cool little nod to a certain Undertale character in Toriel's classroom. Just inspect the poster with the shapes on it. I wonder who made that.